my name is Harjot and you are watching Ford Love Gadgets. To begin with, apologies for the delay in the schedule as far rolling out these videos is concerned, as I had a family exigency and lost someone we loved a lot. I'll not get into the detail, but then here we are. As far as this video is concerned, we are reviewing these 5 tempered glasses as we have shown in the teaser, and we have not only compared them, we have reviewed them in detail. So first you will see the comparison as compared to each other with respect to the width, the height, the bezels, as in left hand side, right hand side, bottom, the top cutout, everything we have covered. And then we are moving to the review section wherein we put these onto the phone one by one and see how's the fingerprint scanner working, do we have to reset it, two, also how's the touch response, three, how much is the bezel covering the entire glass, are they curved, how about putting a different cover, last but not the least, is the speaker getting hindered or not. So everything we are covering. Most important fact that we have covered is if we put them through some scratch test, as to scratching them by cutter or some rusted coins and so on, how do they react to those scratches, are those scratches visible with naked eyes, or you can see them with some light onto the glass in a certain angle. So we have captured that. Now the video is lengthy because these are 5 tempered glasses which we have put onto the phone one by one. We have ensured that we show continuity so that you do not feel as we are playing smartly. And another important thing that I would like to highlight is that these are something that we have bought with our hard-earned money. These are not review tempered glasses, so the feedback would be unbiased. Thus, what are we waiting for? Please do subscribe to the channel, as that really motivates and you are the fuel. Hit the bell icon for all. Do comment and let us know which is the one you like the most. Also, share the video with your friends and family. If you have a query, fire it away. I'll try to ensure that we reply back in 24 hours, which we generally do, in certain situations as we are occupied with other things, then only it gets delayed. But I personally try to reply that within 24 hours. So without wasting any time, let's start. And I ensure that again, this would be one stop video for you all to see which is the best tempered glass.
So we are starting with Johora 9D edge-to-edge tempered glass. The next one is SKV edge-to-edge tempered glass. Okay, glad it's different. You then have the JG World edge-to-edge full HD tempered glass. Now this is for $149. So packaging is top-notch, guys. It is indeed top-notch. I just hope it's not similar. And okay, no, it is not. Okay, I'll keep this here. Good that you got the wipes in this one, right? So basically so far we have got these three, right? Let's unpack the other two and we'll compare them before we put them onto the phone. Okay, now I'll move to the fourth one, which is the Jump Start. This is basically the most costlier one. And then we are left with the Hammerproof Nanofilm Realme X by Knapp phone. Let's unpack this as well. I'm again keeping them aside. The only reason I'm trying to show you is just to make as much as clarity, so that you don't feel like I've changed something or swapped something. A tempered glass which comes in similar packing. Wow. Okay, is it similar to anyone? No, it is not. This is good, guys. See, I mean, they have given this sheet to cleanse it and the wipes, and this is really good, right? Any guesses as to what is this similar to? But this is nice. I'll keep it here. And the last one, the Knapp font. Great, I am liking the size, but let's see when we put these on, how would these gonna fit? So these are our 5 tempered glasses. Let's quickly take this one as well out of it, right? Okay. Now since this is flexible, I'll keep this aside for a second. Let's have a look at these four tempered glasses. Yep. Okay. Now if I zoom in, let's see if there is any major difference with respect to the side border, top border, and all that. So I'm kind of zooming in a little bit, right? So guys, if we look into the left hand side border, in all the cases, right, in all the cases I'm not finding much of a difference. Let me know if you do see some, but I don't see. Similarly, check it on the right hand side if there would be any. I know there would not be, but it's just that, you know, some people may say that you haven't checked the right side. Likewise, you did check the left side, so that's why I'm doing it, guys. You know, because har ek friend zaruri hota hai, right? So every subscriber is important. Now similarly, just if we see here again, no major difference you can find. Tap here. Now you can see that all of them has a cutout to make sure that the speaker is not affected due to the tempered glass, which is good. So I'm finding the top thickness of the border also similar. Now I think that the opening on this one is a little wider, perhaps these two, and quite possible just the yellow wrapper is different. It could be a, you know, matter of fact that they are same, but then since the wrapper is different, so I cannot say until I put them in. So as you can see that otherwise, as far this area is concerned, it's almost similar on all. Now let's check the bottom bezel. This one has the maximum bezel. Now this one has the maximum bezel, right, followed by this one. So that is why I'm saying that quite possible these might be similar than this, and I think last this. What do you say? So it's probably 1, 2 and then 3. The one at the back, the yellow one, is pasted a little high, that's why it's coming up taller. But if we have a look, so there's not much of a difference in width, as you all can see. So I think the width is same. It's a great thing that the Realme X comes with a pre-applied tempered glass, so you don't have to worry till the time you get the one that you like the most. I'll peel this off. Now let's take the first one, which is Johora. Let's see how does this fits. Now the gum is fine. I mean, it's not too difficult to take it off, to peel it off. And the glass is fairly thick. Now let's put this onto the Realme X. Now I've adjusted the height of the tripod so that, you know, we get a closer look. Again, moving to the settings. And I'll try to put this in a manner. Now what I'm keeping in mind is the fact that I will try to, you know, not hide the navigation gestures, and then see on the top how does this fits. All right, so let me do that. So guys, we'll not get into the application part. Now let's do one thing. Let's quickly see if the fingerprint scanner works. I have not reset the scanner, so you can see it's working fine. So I don't see a dip in the speed, and as you would have seen, I haven't reset the fingerprint scanner and put in a fresh one. Generally, if that happens, you can simply re-register your fingerprint scanner. Now you can see that the navigation keys are visible, right? You can see the bars. So that's what I've kept in mind, that we'll see that, you know, the bars are not hidden. I'll go to settings once again. Now as a result of this, because we are ensuring that the bars are visible, let's see at the top how much area is left. Right, I'll just turn off the screen. Now there is a decent coverage, guys, across. At the bottom, it has covered the glass properly. On the side, on the left hand side, it's fine. I could have moved it a little to the right, so as you can see here, it's fine. So it's just because of the alignment on the top. So I think this is nice, guys, overall. I hope you would also feel that this is fine. Yes, on the top, again, I think this is just due to a little bit of alignment. Hence here you can see it's covered properly. Now let's see the speaker grill. Now this cutout is fine. So the thing is, this could have been a little shorter so that this area too also gets protected. Now this area would not gonna get protected because the cutout is a little big. That's the only downside I see for this. As far, you know, the touch response is concerned, it's fluid, there's no problem, as you can see, right? The fingerprint scanner is working fine, and considering the price, I think it's a good buy. It's a good buy. Now let's quickly see if this gets scratched easily or not. So I'll just quickly wipe this up. Now this is a coin, however, it's a rough coin. I can definitely, you know, okay, so let's see. I think this might scratch the glass, but let's see how does this works. Okay, now let's use some keys. Let's try the cutter. So guys, generally this is the reason the videos are lengthy, because we do everything. There is a fair bit of noise as well. Let me adjust the focus first of all, or let me turn on the flashlight. So there is a fair bit of noise. Now this is a aluminium piece, as in broken from a can, because they are razor sharp. So you can hear that noise, right? Now let's wipe this and see if there's any impact.
From scratch perspective, with naked eyes, you would not gonna see them unless you put light on the glass at a certain angle like this. Now this is what actually has happened if you see carefully. And otherwise, you know, it's not too deep, it would not gonna impact. And with naked eyes, it's not visible. Only at a certain angle with some light, you probably may end up seeing them. This tempered glass is highly recommended. The only downside you have to keep in mind is that the cutout over here is a little big. If this could have been a little shorter, like till here only, just covering the speaker grill, I would have given it 5 out of 5. On that note, let's move to the next tempered glass.
Now moving on to the SKV edge-to-edge tempered glass. This is for 129. Let's take this off from the... Wow, the gum is hard. Let me just put the phone aside and... Okay. Now the gum is better. I won't say better, but it's like on the tougher side as compared to the previous one. I found that one good as well, so no complaints over there. So you have to be very careful. Okay, I'll keep this here. Bringing the phone in the picture. Now again, turning on the settings. A lot of people ask that how much this, you know, will take to go away. It can take 4 days, 5 days. Okay, first thing first, fingerprint scanner works fine. No issues. So you can see that I'm not resetting it, right? Now I have positioned it in a manner that the, you know, navigation bars are visible clearly, right? As you can see. So the touch response is good as well. As you can see, there is no issue. Let's quickly check the fitting overall, how it is. Focus. Yeah. So you can see the edges are covered nicely. At the bottom, it's a little short. But then I think this part generally would get covered by a cover as well. Similarly, on the right hand side as well. So there's very less room, guys, as you can see. Yep. So it's not too much to complain. Let me just try to focus this once again. So you can see. Now this is the best part that I was explaining in the first tempered glass as well, that the speaker grill is covered to the point, right? So there's not too much area which is exposed. So this is how it should have been in the first case as well. I would have given it 5 out of 5. As we say, no one is 100%. Now, as far as this tempered glass is concerned, guys, for 129, it's a great buy. The only thing is that at the bottom, it's like leaving very slight bit of room, right? Let's quickly put some scratches. I'll just quickly wipe it off first because it's a little dirty. Okay, so there we go, right? I'll first of all turn off the flash. Let's scratch it, the good old coin. I've used this one because this is a little rusty, wherein, you know, otherwise the coins that you pick. So I've got this one as well, and there's no point using this because this is so smooth on the side. So what scratches this will put? Good old can case. So there's definitely some noise, as you can hear yourself, right? Let's bring in a key. Every angle, and last but not the least, the Mi Band charge cable. Okay, now before I wipe this off, let me just try to show you if, so you can see this pretty much scratches, or you can see the impression is definitely there, and generally in a real life you would not gonna put this much of impression. Let me wipe this again. Okay. Sorry. Now let's see the impact. I'll first of all turn off the flash and focus. Let's see. So there you can see one. Just a matter of focus. So you can see one and two. Let me turn the flash on now. So I'm just moving the finger so that it keeps on focusing on the tempered glass. So the impressions, again guys, see, this is the kind of impact you would not gonna put on your tempered glass in general life or whatsoever situation. Having said that, these scratches are not visible, you know, with naked eyes. Once again, there has to be a great amount of light that you may have to put in, and that too in some angles, because see, can you see something? You would not. But as you do it like this, you would be finding some signs. These are not even scratches, it's just that some impressions. So once again, at this price, this is a good buy once again. Yes, the downside is that at the bottom it did not cover completely. So if you ask me, I think this area generally would get cover, but on the top it's important that the tempered glass should cover. So out of the first two, I'm gonna recommend this one more, if you ask me, if my choice is something you would like to know. Let's move to the third one. Now this is the third one, which is JG World. It comes in this sort of packing, which I was really surprised to see for a tempered glass, which is just 149 rupees. Now the quality is not good, guys. As you can see, at least this piece, I'm not sure if it's broken. It doesn't seem like it's broken, but let's see. I'll quickly take the peel off, as in the skin off. It come out quite easily. Let's put this onto our Realme X. Okay. Alright, first thing first, fingerprint scanner. I was just checking if that's a particle or a problem with the glass. I have a little doubt that this might be glass itself, but I'll check, because even if it's a particle, it's just looking as if it's, you know, a little bit up, as in there's a problem in the glass. But as I, you know, move the finger along, I don't see that rise in the glass itself. Anyways, the fingerprint scanner works fine, no issues in that. Let's see if the bars are visible. So once again, we have put it in a way that we could see the bars, as you can see, right? Now, as for the corners, let's have a look at that. Focus. So this takes a little bit of time. Same thing, guys, this area is exposed. So that's why I felt that the first and the third glass is of similar type. Let's see from this side if there's any issue. And the down part, okay. So I think the first glass and this one is same, is just that the sticker is different, wherein this they have made a Gorilla Glass. And if you would have seen, it mentions that for F11 Pro. Seems like the K, you know, Realme X, Oppo K3 and F11 Pro may have a similar size, but any which ways. Once again, guys, the glass is good. Now, as far this one is concerned, I would suggest that I'll keep it at the third place. The only reason is that the gum is not strong enough. You can see. I mean, I am finding it the least strong in the, you know, cases reviewed. But then with respect to fitting, no problem. With respect to fingerprint, no problem. Overall, the bezels that are left exposed are not complaint worthy. I'll now quickly check the last thing. Okay, before we move on, let's quickly put some scratches. Try to see if this is scratch proof or not. Okay. The good old, wow, you hear that? Sorry. I'll quickly wipe all of this with a piece of cloth. Sorry. Okay, let's put the thumb here and see. Though I think there are no scratches, but yes, some impressions. But I'll just wipe this once again. So this is a little deep than what I sorry for that expected. Same here. And you see, it's just like, you know, if it's a bubble, right? Because it just feels like the glass is defective a little bit. And as usual, at the bottom, you must have seen in the beginning that the border was not properly put in, and it's rough here. If it focus, right? So this is a little rough, so it's like it's kind of broken. So this is broken, you can see, right? Okay, let's put this, take this off. And let's see if there are any particles. So yes, guys, I was right. So there is a bubble in the glass itself. So this is not let me just throw some light. So this is a defect in the glass, right? You may not be able to feel it with your hand or your finger. So it's kind of inverted towards the screen, so that's why. On this note, I think as far as this is concerned, I would not recommend it, because one, they have sent a broken piece. Two, this is again an issue, as you can see now, right? So please don't buy this and waste your money, as simple as that. Let's move to the fourth one. This is the fourth tempered glass, which is from Jumpstart Store. Now the packaging is similar to the glazed ink. What you get inside is this tempered glass. You get wipes and a damp cloth as well. Instructions on the left as to how you clean, peel, align and load the screen protector. Now wherein glazed ink cost around 500, this costed 249. We have also reviewed the glazed ink for Redmi K20 Pro and trust me, it's just fine. It's not an exceptional glass. The link is there in the card. Have a look at that video. Now you can also share the feedback on WhatsApp, Amazon as well as Gmail, which is great. And they sell other products, so I'm not, you know, doing their promotion, but it's just that, you know, my job is to highlight everything. The gum is strong, guys. All right, now I think that the alignment is fine from both the sides as well. Previously, it was not. Let's check the fingerprint scanner. So it's good that in all the four glasses, we don't have to reset the fingerprint scanner and it's working fine. I don't feel, you know, a lag in the speed as well. The touch response is good too. Let's quickly turn on the flash and have a look at the corners. Focus, yep. So this is fine. I don't see any problem. Now again, good thing is that the speaker grille is perfectly covered and the sides are not exposed. This is a perfect fitting as well, right? Let's see the corners. There is a bit of room here. Let's check the other side. I think it's neck to neck. Nothing much I'll complain. But yes, the chin, there's a deep, so this is a little deep than what I think we have seen so far. As I'm making the review back to back, so we'll see once again as we go back and I'll mention in comments if this is too deep. But yes, this is on the higher side. With the cover on, yes, this would get reduced. But then if you just use the phone like this, then this is not good. So once again, if you are using the phone like this, probably stay away from this tempered glass, or maybe you have to, you know, change the alignment that you can push it a little down, right, to have that even exposure on top and bottom, right? But otherwise, I'm happy with the gum. Let's see what is the status of the scratch impression. So, number one. I'm sure that in real life, the tempered glass that we use, they don't go this much of abuse. Abuse. Okay, let me wipe this off. Okay, interesting. Right. I'm just turning the flash now. So this is what we have got on this one. Okay, on this one, these have got registered more prominently as far the previous glasses were concerned. Okay. But then let's do this. So guys, as I mentioned, yes, I'll not back off from my statement that on this one, and they have got registered more prominently, right? Okay, so there you go, guys. So far, we registered 4 tempered glasses. This is otherwise good, but then these impressions are more prominent, keeping in mind that, you know, you put a cover or not, considering this area is concerned, if you move the tempered glass a little lower, because otherwise from fitting, from quality, I mean, it's good, unless you think that your tempered glass would gonna go through the same amount of abuse that we have just put this across, then don't buy it. If you think it would be way lesser than what I did, so you can definitely go for this one. It's not that bad. But yes, as far the overall 4 tempered glasses are concerned, I'll let you know as we just go through the last one. So guys, moving to the 5th one, which is the Napfon hammerproof glasses, as in protection sheets, and they are worthless. Don't buy them. See how much coverage the back section is providing. Though they are flexible and hammerproof, I just wonder that, you know, they could have been of some good size. I know that the Realme X is a little tapered on the sides, so they may not be able to cover the entire section and may come off as you try to apply them, but then this is waste of money. I may agree with the seller at the back part, despite, you know, it could have been a little broader, but look at the front section, guys. Let me focus. See how much is this covering. It's basically keeping in mind the bottom bezel, and still, you know, it lacks the screen protection on the top with a quite decent margin. So we can right away conclude, do not waste your money on these two, guys.
So guys, time to conclude. As far as the tempered glasses are concerned, we were very happy with the Johara tempered glass as well as the SKB1 that we reviewed. They are very, very good as compared to the rest of the lot. As far as the JG World is concerned, that was pathetic. We were not happy with the kind of quality of the tempered glass, and it was broken from the edge as well. As far as the last one with respect to, you know, tempered glasses is concerned, which is the Jump Store, which was from the Jump Store, it is good. It's just that at the bottom we found that, you know, it was a little shorter, as in more shorter than the first two that we reviewed, as you can see in the video. Coming to the last one, which is the Napfon hammerproof glass or tempered sheet. So these are not at all useful, guys. These are basically a joke, as always we have got, but just to make sure that, you know, you get to know, we always buy these. We have bought for Redmi Keroni Pro as well, and they were useless as well. We have bought this for Realme X as well, just for you guys, so that, you know, because generally people do say that, you know, please if you can review that. So we every time buy it just to give you guys a review as to is it something you should spend your money on or not. So hope, guys, this video answers all your queries, as we have reviewed 5 tempered glasses. I think this covers quite a good spectrum. If you have a query, do let me know, and I'll be more than happy to answer. On that note, please do subscribe the channel, as it really helps, and you guys are the fuel. Do click the bell icon for all, and also let me know if you have any query. Fire it away, we'll be more than happy to reply. We generally reply in 24 hours, but in case it takes long, we are maybe, you know, occupied with something else. But yes, in 24 hours I'll definitely would reply to it. Do share the video with your friends and family, and keep watching for the love of gadgets. This is Arjot signing off. Take care and Jai Hind.